Sorry po, naputol po tayo. Sorry. So nagkaroon po ng pananampalataya si Ruth sa ating Panginoon. And through that faith, nakita niya yung kahalagahan ng dedication and commitment to take care of Naomi, no po, her mother-in-law. So dahil po sa famine, there was a famine in Canaan during that time, no po, they decided to go to Bethlehem, Moab, which is in Bethlehem po, because of the famine. And magkasama na po si Ruth at saka si Naomi, they go back to Bethlehem. And through Ruth ay pinrovide niya po ang lahat ng pangangailangan ni Naomi because she was old already. So she is the one working on a field that was owned by Boaz. May, malapit na kamag-anak po ito nila Naomi, no po. At through that nagtatrabaho po si Ruth sa field, no po, at namumulot ng mga nahulog ng mga barley sa farm na yon, no po, na pag-aari ni Boaz, no po. And through that dedication of Ruth to provide for her needs and the needs of her mother-in-law, napansin po ito ng mga tao and ng mga tao sa paligid niya, no po. Instead of going back to her family, she decided to take good care of Naomi, no po, her mother-in-law. At ito din po yung sipag ni Ruth ay nakatawag ng pansin sa mga tao sa paligid, which is supposed to be not the country or not the place of Ruth, but it was the place of Elimelech and Naomi. So foreigner po si Ruth sa lugar na yan. But her dedication to take good care of her mother-in-law, napansin po ito ng mga tao sa paligid, na dapat ay against sila kay Ruth because he was a foreigner, but because of her dedication and yung kanya pong hard work to provide for Naomi, Ruth were able to win the hearts of the people sa land po na ng Bethlehem sa Moab. At even though she was a foreigner, ay nakuha niya po yung puso at pagtitiwala at pagmamahal ng mga tao sa paligid niya during those time. And not only that, even yung owner po ng farm na pinagtatrabahuhan niya, ay nakuha niya yung si Boaz po, nakuha niya yung attention at nakuha niya yung dedication ni Ruth at pagmamahal sa kanyang mother-in-law. Kasi malapit na kamag-anak po siya nila Elimelech at saka po ni Naomi. And because of that generosity of love, care, and affection that was shown by Ruth, nagkaroon po ng affection po si Boaz sa ginagawa ni Ruth, no po. At pinagsabihan niya po na yung kanyang mga trabahador, no po, na bigyan ng barley o ng inaani si Ruth, no po, at huwag pahirapan at huwag pagbawalan. So Ruth were able to caught the attention of Boaz. And through that, no po, ay nagkaroon po ng relationship yung dalawa at naging asawa po ni Boaz si Naomi, no po. Nakita po natin dito yung paghihirap, yung dedication, yung hard work at yung napakagandang puso ni Ruth na even she was a foreigner in that country, nakuha niya po yung attention at pagmamahal din ng mga tao sa paligid niya. And even the owner of the field wherein she gathered barley sa mga natatapon po sa gilid lamang, ay natawag po ang atensyon ni Boaz, the owner of the field. At yun nga po, binigyan siya ng ng instruction ni Boaz sa kanyang mga tauhan na huwag pahirapan si Ruth at bigyan ng extra na mga natatapon. Bukod sa natatapon, bigyan ng extra barley na mapupulot si Ruth. And at the end of that story ay naging mag-asawa po si Ruth at saka po si Boaz. So we could see the what are the points that we are seeing in this story, that even in the hardship of the situation, no po, that after losing his husband, no po, si Ruth was been too dedicated and too concerned, and she loves her mother-in-law Naomi. And with that clean intention of the heart to work and to provide for Naomi, ay binigyan po siya ng mas malaking pagpapala ng Panginoon. Yung act of love ni Naomi, ni Ruth towards Naomi, her mother-in-law, ay nagbukas po ng napakalaking opportunity, napakalaking kapalit ng kanyang pagmamahal at sacrificial love niya sa kanyang mother-in-law. Nagkaroon po ito ng magandang bunga. At naging on, since she became the husband of Boaz, the owner of the field where she is working and picking up excesses of the barley na natatapon po, ay naging owner din po siya ng field na pag-aari ni Boaz. So we could see na even in the darkest moment of our lives, katulad po ni Ruth na namatay yung kanyang asawa, and even Naomi, no po, na namatay po yung kanyang asawa din at namatay din po yung mga anak niya, ay the Lord touches the heart of Ruth, no po, to love her so much and take good care of her in her old age, no po. So, makita natin yung plano ng Diyos for Naomi, who has a great faith to God din. Hindi rin po pinabayaan ng Diyos yung katandaan ni Naomi because she touches the heart of Ruth to take care of her. And at the same time, yun din pong pangangalaga ng Panginoon sa ganda ng puso ni Ruth towards her mother-in-law, ay biniyayaan din po siya ng Panginoon to have a husband and to own the field where she was working. So makita po natin yung pagmamahal, the sacrificial love of Naomi, no po, and at the same time, that's the sacrificial love of Ruth, di po ba? That yung true love po would calls for self-sacrifice. Parati pong ang pagmamahal ay nangangailangan ng sakripisyo. Pero po yung sakripisyo na yan ay hindi po nawawala ng saysay sa mata ng Panginoon. But because of that sacrificial love, ay it will give more blessing into our lives. At sa situation po ng paglipat nila Naomi at saka nila ni Ruth at saka yung isa pa pong daughter-in-law na si Orpa from Canaan to Bethlehem, ay dumaan po sa hardship sa umpisa ang si Naomi at saka si Ruth, but because they don't know anything about that place, no po, and they have to start all over again because they have transferred from another place to another place, no po, they would need to reestablish themselves, and through that reestablishing, no po, they have faced a lot of hardship to be able to settle in the land where they are new, no po. But through all of this journey and through all these heartaches, because namatay yung asawa ni Naomi na si Elimelech, and also his sons, the husband of Naomi, the husband of Ruth, and Orpa, her daughters-in-law, ay Masakit po yun during that times dahil namatay ang asawa at ang dalawang mga anak. But even through that hardship, no po, and even to the heartaches that Naomi and Ruth was carrying in their hearts, and even the hardship that Naomi and especially Ruth ay yung hardship ng pagsisettle sa panibagong land, most of the time, the hardship that we have in our lives will give us opportunity to see the miracle of the Lord in our life. Kaya po, in every morning of our lives, in every day of our lives, even though it is hard, of course it is hard, no po. But just like Naomi and Ruth, this team of mother and daughter-in-law team were able to manage to come out victoriously on those hardship and heartaches, no po. So this is the same in our lives, no po. Even though we are facing, meron po tayong mga sakit ng kalooban, no po, at lungkot, at kaya hindi naman po ay paghihirap sa ating buhay, we could have confidence and faith that God prepares something better for us. We should never waver with our faith, and we should not waver with our hope that the darkness that we are in right at this moment and the heartaches that we have in our heart at this very moment will lead to light, will lead to more blessing. There will always be tomorrow, no po, and God will always make a way for us. Even how dark these days were, even how lonely these days were, even how hopeless this moment in our lives, we have to have faith and hope in God that there is a new tomorrow, that there will be a new beginning in our life. That God is just working at the moment, and He will deliver us from any sorrows, from any hardship that we are facing in our life. Our faith will play a great importance in our life to be confident and with enough trust in the Lord and hope in the Lord that tomorrow the sunrise will shine upon our lives, and blessing and answer to all the hardship and to all our prayers will be given by God. When there seems to be no way, there is always a way in us, in God, and He will deliver us from any hardship that we are facing nowadays. That there is a way when there seems to be no way. Kaya po, siguro po ang number one na makikita natin sa buhay ni Ruth ay yung kanyang pagmamahal na na-develop po sa kanyang mother-in-law. Well, in fact, ngayon po at our present generation, marami pong mga mother and daughter-in-law na mag-aaway kung bakit yun agad ang nasa the back of our minds pagka merong pumasok sa ating pamilya. Daughter or son-in-law, no po, parang we are anticipating that there will be some hardship to face. Pero of course, it at the beginning pwede po yan, but just like Naomi, who was able to share her faith, no po, to her daughters-in-law, siguro po maganda rin pong simula na yung pong daughters and son-in-law na pumapasok sa ating buhay is we able to build yung character, no po, na natin, yung mga father or mother-in-law na una nating ma-share is yung love of God in our lives, and it will be easier. We might have a son-in-law or a daughter-in-law just like Naomi, whose love and dedication to us, no po, ay higit pa sa ating mga anak. So, yung pong love, we should always express and let our love for our son or son-in-law and daughter-in-law na maramdaman po nila yung pagmamahal. And they will be able to reciprocate that kind of love. Yun po. Yung pagmamahal ni Naomi sa kanyang mother-in-law ay sumasagot din sa ilang mga Bible verses na nasa let us take care of our widows. Yun po. Let us honor and respect our parents. Yun po. Sumasagot din po si Naomi dun sa mga pinag-uutis din ng Bible na we should honor and respect our parents and we should love our widows, na po, take good care of our widows. Marami po tayo ngayon na meron po tayong kasamang ina na widow na po or ama na widow na po, we should take good care of them. Na po, katulad ng ginawa ni Ruth. Si Ruth po ay matututunan po na natin na napakaraming positive values ang meron kay Ruth. Kaya po, she is the best. She is an epitome of a woman in a family life. No po. Ang dami po nating matututunan na character na meron si Ruth sa istorya niya po. And we could see also that Ruth become a redeemer of Naomi's life, no po. Siyempre po, matanda na at balo pa si Naomi. Parang wala nang kahulugan ang buhay niya, no po. Pero at very dim yung future niya dahil din siya makakapagtrabaho, di po ba? At wala na siyang kamag-anak o wala na siyang anak at wala na rin yung mga stepdaughters, mga daughters-in-law niya, di po ba? Pero yun nga po, sa ginawa ni Ruth na pangangalaga at pananatili sa piling ni Naomi, naging redeemer po ni Naomi si Ruth. And just the same time, si Boaz po naging redeemer po ni Ruth at saka ni Naomi. So nag-provide din po ng redeemer ng mga ngalaga kay Ruth, no, at kay Naomi in the person of Boaz who became a wife of Ruth, no po. At yun po. So nakita po natin yung plano ng Panginoon sa buhay ni Naomi at saka ni Ruth because of their love for one another, because of their concern for one another. God take good care of them in the person of Boaz, no po. Na iangat po ang kanilang buhay sa pamamagitan ni Boaz na nag-provide sa kanila ng more than what Ruth is providing for Naomi, no po. Dahil she became automatically the owner of the land, of the farm, wherein the real owner is Boaz. And because Boaz became her husband, no po, his husband, kaya po lumaki po yung provisions na provided for Naomi and for Ruth. So, makita po natin dyan yung pagkilos ng Panginoon through the life of Naomi, no po, and Ruth. Yung pong pagmamahal, a sacrificial kind of love, always bear fruits of more love and more blessing in our life. Ano po? So makita po natin na ano po yung impact ng life, no, ni Ruth na matatagpuan natin sa Bible. Number one, there is hope even in the most devastating times of our life. Not only with Ruth, but also with Naomi, because they were suffering internally because both of them lost their husband, and Naomi even lost her two sons. So even during the devastating hour of our life, there will always be hope in the Lord. And the number one question, of course, in the mind and hearts of Naomi, where they will get food and provision to live, no po. At yun din po siguro yung concern niya dun sa kanyang dalawang daughters-in-law, kaya pinababalik niya sa kanilang mga pamilya dahil namatay na din po yung mga asawa na anak ni Naomi. So there is hope even in the most devastating times of our life. The book of Ruth begins by looking the life of Naomi. After moving to Moab with her husband and son, she loses her husband and becomes a widow. Just 10 years after her son died too, it seems that Naomi's entire life is crumbled in those years. In fact, when she returns to Bethlehem, her heart is crushing and heart wrenched of losing a child. Kaya po yung moment na yon, and Ruth is also a widow, and of course, even though she expressed expresses willingness to be dedicated in taking good care of Naomi, still there are questions in her mind, in the heart and mind of Ruth, where he will going to get the provision to take care of Naomi, her mother-in-law. But again, we could see that through the maneuvering act of God, he provided for everything they need, and more than that pa. But one exact point that both Naomi and Ruth have is their faith in God. No po. Na-share na nga po ni Naomi kay Ruth yung pananampalataya sa Panginoon. Kaya po, during their hard times of their lives, no po, devastating time of their life, there is one thing that they have both in their heart, their faith and hope in God, that the Lord will actually going to take good care of them, even though they don't know how. Yung pong life nila, when they started to travel, to transfer to Bethlehem, they know they will going to Bethlehem, but they didn't know the exact future that they will going to have, and they didn't know where to start and to begin their life together. All they have is their faith and hope, and the two of them together will work it out with God's faith sa ating Panginoon. So there is hope even in the most devastating time of our life. And what are the other lessons that we could learn from the life, from the book of Ruth? Lesson number two po is that the past is not our final destination when we trust God. Yes, of course, nakita po natin dito. That even though that Ruth and Naomi became widow, that was already the past. We don't have to dwell on the past in our life, the heartaches in our lives, and stay there, or in the darkness of our past, we stay there. No, we should go further. We should move further. We should move forward with our trust in the Lord. That past is not our destination when we trust God. Ito po. Bisan po talaga, very, very major yung nararamdaman nating trials and challenges in our lives, no po. Daily, we are facing that. And it seems to be that we are in a darkened place of our lives, no po. In a scarcity moment of our lives, no po. And it's become too hard that everything is dark, no po. There is no hope, no po. But we should always be moving forward with our life, with the use of our trust and confidence in God, that the Lord will going to take us into another kind of life. We will not stay in darkness, but we will have the light of tomorrow. There is hope in tomorrow with our faith and trust in God. So yan po number two, the past is not our final destination when we trust God. When we trust God, there is always hope. There will always be freedom. Even though during the darkest moment of our life, we are assured of that the Lord is making a way. And there's always a way for God. Even in our darkest moment of life, there will always be light that will shine upon our way. At number three po, doing the right thing often takes great sacrifice. Even though in the darkest moment of our life, we should always choose and decide to do what is right, even though it is hard times. We should always have to make decisions and choices that to do the right things over what is happening in our lives. And most often than not, great sacrifice is needed to create changes in our life. At yung pong great sacrifice na yan, dito po pinakita ni Ruth yung love niya at yung sacrificial act of love niya to take care of her mother-in-law brought her to much more blessings. So doing the right things often takes great sacrifice. Yan po. And number four, sharing openly about our relationship with God brings intimacy to relationship. Opo. So as we have this said already, na yung pong faith ni Naomi over the Lord, she was able to share it with her daughters-in-law, especially with Ruth. At sa pamamagitan po ng sharing niya, nagkaroon ng deep faith si Ruth sa ating Panginoon. And because of that, she was able to give an act of love to her mother-in-law to take care of her. And that kind of love needed a sacrifice en route to be able to take good care of her mother-in-law. And because of Naomi sharing the relationship with God, no, it brings intimacy. It creates an uppermost level of intimacy of the relationship between Ruth and Naomi, her mother-in-law. And it opens a great act of faith towards God. Yung pong relationship nila nakatulong sa pagbibuild up ng yung pong faith ni Naomi nakatulong sa pagbibuild up ng relationship niya between the two of them, Ruth and Naomi. And number five, in this story of Ruth, we could see a preview of Christ's redeeming power. We could see yung pong essence ng Christ's redeeming power. Since this is the Old Testament, it was been suggested na yung ginawa po ni Ruth towards taking care of Naomi, her mother-in-law, is a redeeming value, no po, na katulad ng ginawa ni Kristo sa ating buhay, no po. Ni-redeem tayo ng ating Panginoong Hesus Kristo, taken us away from the sins of this world. Yun din naman po, redeeming value si Ruth. Pinakita po yung redeeming value niya towards Naomi na wala pong mahihirapan si Naomi because she was old already. But the redeeming value, an act of love and sacrifice in the part of Ruth to take good care of her mother-in-law, no po, she redeemed the life of Naomi during her old age. And even the act of Boaz to offer marriage to Ruth becomes also a redeeming factor ng hardship, ng kind of life ni Ruth and together with Naomi also. So, redeemer din po nila in such a way si Boaz na po. So, there is a redeeming value that we could see, that we could conclude in the life of Ruth, in the book of Ruth. And number six, we must be people of character even when we think no one is watching. Opo. So yun po, yung pong dedication and yung commitment ni Ruth towards Naomi to take good care of her and not to leave her alone by herself because she was old already. Nung pong dedeclare ito ni Ruth kay Naomi to that she wanted to stand by her side, no, wherever she go, whatever she do, wherever she live or die, dun po rin yung gustong puntahan ni Ruth, no, to be together with Naomi all the way, no po. So yung pong karakter na yan ni Ruth ay nakita po sa kanyang mga kilos at gawa ng mga tao doon sa bagong lugar na kinakalagay niya. And Naomi managed to earn the respect and the love of the people around them, no po. And even the love and respect of Boaz, no po. Kaya nga po siya napili ni Boaz na mapang-asawa because yung karakter ni Naomi was manifesting in her life even without talking, even without telling the people, ay nakita po yung true character ni Ruth, no po, sa pagmamahal at lahat ng magagandang character traits in taking good care of Naomi, no po, na-reveal yung true character ni Ruth. At number 7 po, God uses unlikely people for His purpose. Yes, opo, ito po. Parati pong ito. Yung mga underdogs po, no po. Yung mga nobodies, no po. Parati po siyang ginagamit ng Panginoon to serve His purpose upon His people, no po. And Naomi is just an ordinary mother-in-law. And Ruth is also an ordinary daughter-in-law without prominence, without title in them, no po. But through their life, Naomi's life and Ruth's life, he was able to use them to share with us about the word, how the Lord works in the lives of ordinary people. He normally uses unknown people, underdogs people throughout the Bible. Marami po tayong mamimit ng mga hindi naman mga prominent people. And most of the time, the Lord is not using prominent people, but simple people, ordinary people, people with character flaws. Yun po yung mga ginagamit niya, nobody, no po, to declare His glory and honor. No po. And this is what had happened between in the person of Naomi and Ruth. No, they were ordinary mother-in-law and ordinary daughter-in-law, but they were able to be a part of the Bible, no po. At yung life po nila, yung love and life nila was able to touch a lot of people. Even at this very moment when we are sharing this inspiration, we could learn a lot from them. Napili po siya ng Panginoon, ordinary girl, ordinary woman, ordinary daughter-in-law, and ordinary mother-in-law. But they have a deep insight that the Lord was able to use them, their life as a story to be shared in the Bible. They were able to be a part of the Bible. Di po ba? When you are a part of a Bible, of course, you have meaning. That we could dwell on and look and study and exhaust what are the lessons that we could learn from this ordinary woman, Naomi and Ruth. So that's the point po, no po. Just like what had happened to Naomi and Ruth, no po. Even in our ordinary kind of life, our hardship, our heartaches, our darkest moment in our life, our past, no po. God will always have His grace towards us. Madalas po, we don't earn this, no po, yung grace of God's love and provision. He's just a God of faithfulness who never changes. Ngayon, kailanman ay hindi nagbabago ang Diyos. And His grace, no po. Minsan, we don't deserve these graces that is happening in our life. But because God is a gracious God, no po. Kaya po may mga bagay na nangyayari sa atin na we don't deserve, but we receive the grace of God. Ganyan po si Lord, no po. Even we don't deserve this, God is gracious, no po. He doesn't choose or He doesn't discriminate people. Because He was God and He will use His gracefulness towards all the people, whether we deserve it or not. Because God is a gracious God. Yun lamang po. Period po yun. Minsan hindi natin mauunawaan. But it is happening. It is happening to our sons and daughters. They don't deserve the what is happening in their life, but because God is gracious, that is only the answer. Because God is gracious. If He wants to be gracious to us, He will be gracious with us, even if we don't deserve it. That is our God. Our God is a big God. So let us all be inspired and motivated. Even what kind of hardship we are facing, just like the life of Naomi and Ruth, God has a promise for us that He will take good care of us, and He has a great plan over our lives. So this morning po, I hope we are very much inspired with our story of Ruth and Naomi, and let us dwell into the presence of God, having faith and confidence that the Lord will open the door for us, even during the time that all the doors and windows are closed, still God will make a way to touch our life. Happy Monday po, and this is with a prayer that we will be having a whole happy and blessed weekdays ahead of us. God bless po. Thank you po.